Hi, welcome to How to Repair. This video is on self-test diagnostic mode on LG's new washing machines. This is from 2020 onwards, and I'll be going through all the test procedure and also explaining what you should be looking for if you're trying to find faults with your machine. Before I go into diagnostic mode, I just want to explain a couple of things that you need to keep an eye on during the video. I've got my smart meter up here that tells me the voltage, the ampage, the wattage, and my total energy consumption during a cycle if I wanted to reset it. I have done another video on these so you can actually understand how beneficial they are for understanding what's going on with a washing machine. Now, all the parts on this machine, on the new ones, have actually got part numbers on for a change, which makes it so much easier for the general public to be able to get the correct component for their machine, and it's so helpful to engineers as well. Second thing I love about these machines, by the way, is they've still got split drums, meaning you can change the bearings and spider in the machine in 10 years or so when you need to. There's so many machines on the market today that have sealed drums, and I hate built-in obsolescence, and LG have done a fantastic job of building this new designed machine. Okay, to enter diagnostic mode is different from the old one. The old one, you used to press two buttons at the same time you press the start button, but on the new machines, you have to press the on-off button and then the second and fourth button to enter diagnostic mode. This needs to be done within 1 second of actually pressing the on-off button. You will hear the door lock energize. That's the first test it's doing. The LEDs are all displayed to check the bulbs and everything else, and the software version is in the middle of the screen here. Okay, whenever doing a test on the machine, all you need to worry about is pressing the start button. Every time you press the start button, it will go through a feature of the test diagnostic sequence. Now, they have built in many steps for all types of machine. Let me explain. A machine that has either a hot water valve or maybe is a washer dryer may have additional water valves that it would be testing. So at some points during the test procedure, it may not do any function at all. This is because it is designed to test other components. This machine has only got one pump on it, which is the emptying pump. Some machines have two pumps because it has a recirculation pump. So the test sequence will vary. Test 1 will actually test the motor on this machine in a clockwise rotation and energize the pump as well to empty any water. It will show on the display the RPM that the machine is doing. This is doing 45, as I said, other machines may be doing 50. The next step will be pump energized again and also increasing the RPM of the machine up to around 50% of its maximum capacity. This machine is a 1400, but this test sequence will go up to 600 RPM. You'll notice that it only shows 59 on the actual dial. You have to actually, in your head, put an extra zero on. Some models may be showing the exact 600. The next test you do is increasing the RPM with the pump again up to the maximum capacity of the machine, and this will be somewhere close to 1400 RPM. You can see on the actual display now it's showing 137. This is 1370 RPM. The next test sequence, we press the button, we'll be going into testing the water valves at the back of the machine, but they will not energize until the drum has stopped rotating. What you can see on the screen now is 255. This is the pressure switch telling the actual program what level of water is in the machine. Our empty drum frequency is 255. Our maximum level on this machine is 229. That is where it will stop allowing the water valves to work. Let me explain. We have here a sump hose, and on certain machines the pressure chamber is attached to the drum. On other machines it is attached to the hose, like here. This is then connected with a pipe that goes through to the pressure switch. The pressure switch basically sends a reading to the actual program. As the water fills up inside this chamber, it pressurizes the air, therefore sending the pressure to the switch, which is able then to actually tell the program what level of water it is at. You will see on the dial here, as water is entering the machine, that this number is going down. It will continue to go down, and water is coming in on the right-hand valve. And this is testing that valve. If no water was coming in, the first thing you need to be doing is actually doing a meter check on the water valve to make sure it's got power, and also doing a test on the solenoid itself to make sure it hasn't burnt out and you don't have, or you have continuity. The next time we press this button, it will change over onto the other water valve. This will continue filling. We're at 239 at the moment, and this will continue filling until, like I said, it gets to the reading of 229. This is where it would have stopped allowing water to enter the machine. Now, the next step, I press it, but it just continues filling. Well, at that point, it may be testing another water valve. And we'll let this continue filling now until 229, where you will see that the water level in the drum has got to roughly equivalent to a full rinse cycle, and it will not allow any more water to come into the machine. Okay, you can see now that the machine is at 230 and the water has just started covering the seal at the bottom of the drum. These frequency levels may vary from machine to machine depending on the software and also the program that is set up. But you heard the water turn off. It will turn on and off a couple of times to make sure it stabilizes correctly at 229. This is how machines are so capable now of having accurate water readings to make sure they're more energy efficient. The old type pressure switch system used to be a mechanical pressure switch system, and that would vary very differently to the new type ones. They're much more accurate. Now, our next rotation, pressing it once, actually nothing happens. This may be testing the circulation pump if you have a different model of machine. The next test sequence will be doing an anticlockwise rotation at 45 RPM, the same as the earlier test that we did on number one. The next time I press the button, you want to be looking at this meter. It is going to test the frequency going from the NTC sensor to read the temperature, and that is measured in ohms. It will also energize the heating element to make sure the heating element comes on and everything is working correctly. Press it, look at the meter, 9 amp, and it was pulling just over 2 kilowatt. Water temperature is 15. The next time I press this, it will go into an empty procedure. You can hear it emptying. These new motors for the pumps are much quieter than the old motors, and this is why they are so much more energy efficient as well. This pump, under load, is only pulling 33 watts of power. And we'll let this completely empty, and you can see the frequency now going back towards 255. When the drum is completely empty, the machine will know because it reads 255. You heard the pump cavitating, and it's 255. That's all working perfectly. The next time we press this, it will just end the program. Our favorite tune as usual. Pressing stop will stop the test sequence and reset the program to work normally as usual. So you're able to start the machine to whatever cycle you require, or you're able to do the work on the machine. I hope this video was helpful. Please remember to subscribe to the channel, as that's what keeps us going and able to make these videos for you. And remember to mark us down to your favorites, because there is a whole playlist on these LG washing machines with regards to repairing every component on the machine, whether new or old. Thank you very much indeed for watching, and please remember to shop with us. Thanks again for watching.